The upcoming Starship V3 upgrade is upon us, and excitement is building rapidly. There are many questions about why this version is generating such high expectations, and the answer lies in the extensive upgrades SpaceX is preparing to launch. These modifications are poised to transform Starship's performance and expand its capabilities far beyond its current capabilities. So, what innovations are the hallmarks of Starship V3? And which upgrades are most noteworthy? Let's discuss them all in today's episode of NR Studio. Starship represents a vast and complex system, making it difficult to monitor every change with complete precision. For now, we'll focus on 7 of the most important upgrades. As you observe, you can note which upgrades resonate most with you, or even formulate your own ranking. So, let's get started. One of Starship's defining features has consistently been its sheer size. However, it seems SpaceX isn't done pushing those boundaries yet. The V3 design aims for a larger overall configuration. In this iteration, the booster's height will increase from 71 meters to 72.3 meters, while the spacecraft will remain at the same height of 52.1 meters as seen on V2. Once assembled, the entire V3 assembly will reach a height of 124.4 meters, up from 123.1 meters on the previous model. This expansion is just the beginning, as SpaceX is already targeting even greater dimensions for the upcoming V4 version. Much of the booster's increased height is likely to come from an improved hot staging mechanism, which requires additional length. SpaceX may also add fuel tank sections to improve performance, especially as engine technology continues to evolve. During the initial assembly of the V3 B18 booster, observers also noted the installation of new fuel transfer tubes, indicating further refinements taking place beneath the surface. Starship V3 components will retain the larger dimensions of the V2, with a focus on the fuel tank and payload sections. These improvements aim to optimize flight performance when Starship begins launching operational cargo. Overall, these size increases do more than simply create an impressive appearance. They directly enhance Starship's functionality, efficiency, and long-range capabilities. A second significant improvement comes across both vehicle phases and can be considered the heart of Starship. The introduction of the Raptor 3 marks a new era of innovation. This next-generation engine represents a complete overhaul, delivering significant improvements across all key metrics over the previous version. One of the most significant improvements is its power. The Raptor 3 is expected to produce 280 tons of thrust at sea level and 306 tons in a vacuum. With this achievement, it stands out as the most formidable Methalox engine worldwide, outshining Blue Origin's BE-4. However, the true capability of Raptor 3 lies not just in the power of an individual engine, but in the way SpaceX effectively combines numerous engines. The Super Heavy booster will be equipped with 33 Raptor 3 engines, producing over 9,000 tons of thrust during launch. This thrust measurement positions it as a leader in aerospace history, nearly tripling the thrust output of the Saturn V. The upper stage will incorporate significantly fewer engines, yet its total thrust will still surpass that of many present-day orbital-class rockets. Even this impressive capacity is not the ultimate target. SpaceX's goal is to elevate liftoff thrust beyond 10,000 tons in the future. This may be realized through further enhancements of the engines, increasing the engine quantity, or a combination of both, emphasizing the long-term vision behind the Starship initiative. The enhancements are not limited to just performance. Raptor 3 is characterized by a newfound level of simplicity. Many small, fragile, and highly intricate components found in Raptor 1 and 2 have been entirely eliminated or consolidated into larger, more cohesive assemblies. Consequently, Raptor 3 is much more streamlined, unified in design, and considerably more dependable. This simplification results in significant efficiency improvements. The parts contributing extra weight and unnecessary protective systems like heat shields are no longer required. By getting rid of this surplus weight, the overall vehicle becomes lighter. SpaceX can preferentially allocate more of the total mass allowance to useful cargo rather than supporting structures, enhancing mission performance directly. Furthermore, simplicity also positively impacts every phase of the engine's lifespan. Production becomes considerably less complicated as the optimized design decreases the number of complex manufacturing processes. Raptor 2 already achieved a production rate of one engine per day. Thus, Raptor 3 has the potential to reach several engines daily, facilitating the quick assembly of new prototypes. The operational dependability is also improved by removing small components, tight passages, and bolts that may retain heat or create leaks. Raptor 3 reduces failure points significantly. This lowers the risk of abrupt shutdowns, thermal issues, or unforeseen explosions during flight. The benefits extend even after landing. A less complex engine allows for quicker inspections, maintenance, and refurbishment. This means Raptor 3 can be rapidly prepared for reuse, bringing SpaceX closer to achieving a completely fast and repeatable launch capability. Raptor 3 symbolizes a pivotal moment for Starship operations. Its initial launch is imminent, and following the completion of testing, it will be examined and equipped with its inaugural set of Raptor 3 engines, signaling the start of a new chapter for the program.
As the latest movement of the early V3 boosters indicates, a significant upcoming upgrade is a completely revamped hot staging mechanism. Musk initially teased this advancement earlier this year, but seeing it manifest in a real-world device represents a significant step forward. This innovative design was inspired by the Soviet N1 rocket, which also featured a type of hot staging. Despite this, SpaceX has implemented several key improvements. The most notable modification is that the hot staging segment is no longer a separate ring that separates during flight. Instead, it has been integrated directly into the booster's frame, ensuring it remains part of the vehicle throughout the entire mission, further advancing Starship's path to complete and efficient reusability. Another key aspect of the newly designed hot staging configuration is its focus on minimalism. The connecting elements are now slimmer and less complex than in previous versions, resulting in a lighter and more easily manufactured design. This minimalist approach allows SpaceX to reduce overall weight, shorten production times, and reduce the need for post-flight repairs. Simultaneously, the refined design aims to improve heat dissipation and withstand the extreme pressures generated during stage separation and ignition. Directly beneath this refined system, at the front of the booster, lies a fourth major improvement: restructured grid fins and attached capture points. Previously, the capture points and grid fins functioned as completely separate components. In V3, SpaceX has unified these functions into a single cohesive system. This integration reduces the number of components the booster must support and should facilitate smoother and more predictable handling during descent and landing. The grid fins have also been slightly lowered, now extending to the top of the fuel tank dome. This placement likely reduces the direct impact of the upper stage engines during separation, especially in the newly formed hot staging conditions. To accommodate this integration, the grid fins have been reinforced for increased durability. Their dimensions and design have also been revised, with the overall number of grid fins reduced from 4 to 3, distributed evenly around the booster. This modification maintains Starship's steering and braking capabilities while simplifying manufacturing, simplifying installation, and increasing reusability. These changes include major improvements to the Super Heavy booster. The ship section also received significant upgrades, furthering the overall advancement of the Starship system. The fifth modification introduces a new fueling point, first observed during the initial liftoff of Ship 39. Currently, the point is just an empty structural piece with no internal components installed, located directly below the cargo door. The goal is clear: to serve as an initial test, allowing SpaceX to test the system's performance in a real-world flight scenario. The findings from this evaluation will influence future improvements and its full integration. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next time.